Good morning. My name is Antonio. Some of you may know me as A6. Today, what we're going to be describing or talking about is knowing when to let go of something. Usually, people can get trapped in what's called parasitic relationships. A lot of times, what a parasitic relationship can be is basically somebody or something that's taxing your information, or excuse me, your energy and mental information or energy or whatever you want to call it. It's taxing it from you constantly. It's constantly draining you of your, you can almost say sanity in some situations. It's just every time you turn around, there's always something negative going on. That can constantly drain on you, and it can cause you to feel tired. You can be exhausted mentally. You could just not want to deal with anybody after a certain period of time. These things have to be weeded out in your life because they cause additional stress. Your life can be stressful enough without a parasitic relationship dragging you back. So at what point do you know when to let go? These are some tips that I've developed through the years of being in certain situations, whether it be maybe a relationship with somebody or you're involved in maybe a project or something of that nature. Right now, I can tell you I'm involved with a project of building a car, and it's just become so much stress constantly over and over again, time consuming, emotional lows, like very few highs. It's just become so detrimental to my mind state. I'm deciding right now whether I'm gonna let go or not. So here's some things that I'm considering, okay? So what you need to do is, first off, let's write that here, knowing when to let go. All right, so we got that there. All right, first off, you want to consider all things you can remember about, let's call it X. For me, it's the vehicle I'm building right now. So I've had this vehicle since I was about 18 years old. And I can remember when we first got it, it was my first sports car. I was so excited, I was happy. I couldn't wait to go drive it, man, to show this thing off and just be the man with the car. It was really cool. So, you know, over time, I just remember the moments where the car would break. I had to put the money into it. I had to actually physically fix it myself. A lot of times when it did break, there wasn't enough data on it to find out things. So I had to basically find out things myself. It was a very heavy learning experience for me in terms of all in all. Skip to today around these times. I've got so much going on in life. I really don't even have the patience or time anymore to deal with such a thing. So considering all those moments that I've been through with the vehicle, as well as, good and bad weather, and then what I can deal with right now, that's gonna help me make a decision after we consider a few more steps. So consider all things you can remember about X. So with that said, you gotta consider all the things about X, the goods and the bads, the ups, the downs, the highs, the lows. Everything has to be considered. Compare how much trouble you have been dealt dealing with X. How much drama, how much heartache, how much stress, how much annoyance, how much good, how much bad, how much everything you can think of. How much have you dealt with dealing with it? How you have to compare them. You have to compare the times. Are there more higher times, are there more higher times than there are lows, or is it vice versa? These are things you have to consider. You also need to consider, if you compare how much trouble is right now. Compare how much trouble X has given you. Let's put that there. All right. And then again, you really want to get into comparing the ups and the downs. For something like a relationship, you want to say, okay, how much good is this person bringing to me versus how much negative? How much good, how much bad? Once you start to actually physically compare those things, you'll start to see or have a clearer vision of how you want things to go or where you want to move next. So compare the downs and the ups. You gotta physically, this might help you to write them down. Now what I usually do is, I told you guys this a while back, a few lessons ago, the critical squares, where you take a piece of paper and you fold it in half and then you fold it again. And then when you unfold the paper, you've got four squares. So in each square, you can write a category, 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 and then you can state points in each square. And then you can compare all four squares. So that's a great way to do it. So we'll write that in parentheses. If you don't remember the video, you can check out some of my older videos and they'll actually have the critical squares in them. Yeah, I actually learned that trick in middle school and it stuck with me because I actually was able to use that in life. So it was one of those things in school they actually taught you can apply in life after you got out of school. So yeah, it was one of the few things that I actually utilized from that specific era. Also, you want to realize of all things that will be affected by the ripple effect. So let's say, for instance, you do decide to give up and let this thing go, whatever it may be, thing X, if you decide to let it go, how will the rest of your life be impacted by letting this thing go? If you continue to deal with it, how will your life be impacted, positively and negatively? Some things are not just your decision. Some things are involved in other people's lives as well. So it wouldn't be fair for you to make a decision judged on only you in certain scenarios. Very important to remember that. Depends on what it is. If it's something where it affects your kids, if it's something where it affects your parents or something like that, or your family or friends drastically, positively or negatively, you want to make sure you remember that as well. So some decisions aren't just yours, they affect other people. So you want to realize the ripple effect. Of dealing with X. And again, the ripple effect is people around you, not just you. You're the immediate impact. The ripple effect is everybody else around you. How will they be affected with the decision you make? And that does matter in some certain scenarios. You ultimately have to come to the conclusion whether what you're dealing with will be worth holding on to. Or will you be better off letting go of X? At the end of the day, mainly, it is you who is in charge of living with the decision you make. Whatever choice you come to will be a very thought-out choice. So take a good amount of time to consider. Now, we're going to write that down, but we'll paraphrase. So considering these four things right here, you're going to have to eventually make a decision. Should you continue to deal with a certain thing? Should you deal with it for a certain amount more of time? Or should you just say, I don't want to do this anymore, I'm done? That is your decision to make. But using these four things right here is going to help you make a thought out decision so that you can accurately and sensibly try to decide which way you're going to pay for yourself. So we'll write that down. The decision you make ultimately is yours. Using the above points, will help you make an educated decision. Again, consider all the things you can remember about X. Compare how much trouble X has given you. Compare the ups and the downs. Use the critical squares we discussed before. Realize the ripple effect of dealing with X, positive and negatives, with people around you. And again, once you think about all those things, the decision you make is yours, nobody else's. Using the above points will help you make an educated decision. So that's what we have for today. Join us next week. And we'll have some more things for you to look into. Take it easy.